Hello and welcome to the lecture series on monetary economics. I hope you guys remember that in one of my lectures I have taught you something called as the components of a financial system. For example, say financial institutions, financial markets, financial assets, but they all are incorporated into a very broader sense which is called as the financial or Indian financial system. Yeah, so let us now look at that from a different perspective and just look at a very comprehensive skeleton of the same. Yeah, so Indian financial system can be studied in two broad forms. One is called as the organized or formal institutions, and the second is the unorganized or informal institutions under the Indian financial system. Now, when I talk about organized or formal institutions in the Indian financial system, I have for you certain regulators, then certain financial institutions or intermediaries, then we have financial markets, and then we have financial instruments. Yeah. So these are the four different distinctions which we can see as far as organized financial system is concerned. Yeah, and we are looking at the Indian financial system per se. So now, what are the different types of regulators in the Indian financial system? The first regulator is the Reserve Bank of India, which is also the Central Bank of India or the apex monetary authority in the country. Now we have Reserve Bank of India. On the contrary, the US has Federal Reserve. So this is the apex institution as far as apex monetary institution as far as Indian financial system is concerned. Then we have Securities and Exchange Board of India. Yeah, this is again a regulator which is looking into the money and capital market and things like that. Yeah, then we have Ministry of Finance, obviously, and then we have Insurance Regulatory Development Authority of India, which is IRDA, which is again looking at the insurance regulation and things like that. So these are the four different regulators which are available in the Indian financial market, or the structure of Indian financial systems to be very precise. Yeah, let us now move to something called as financial institutions or intermediaries. So these financial institutions or intermediaries can be seen from four different perspectives. One is called as the banking institutions. We'll get into greater details of each of these, but just for a preliminary sense, banking institutions can be either commercial or cooperative. Yeah, it is commercial or cooperative banks. Yeah, so again, scheduled commercial, non-scheduled and things like that. So in the later lectures I will talk about banking institutions in greater detail, non-banking financial institutions in greater detail. Now the second is, as far as financial institutions or intermediary is concerned, the second is non-banking financial institutions. They can be one, NBFCs, that is non-banking financial companies, and development institutions which are directed for certain developmental purposes. Then we have mutual funds, and the last is insurance and housing finance. So this is again the financial institutions which can be broadly classified further into the four different types. Let us now move to financial markets. Now there are two types of markets. One is called as the money market, which is for the shorter term, and the other is called as capital market, which is for the longer term. Yeah, so it depends upon the assets. For example, in the money market I will be dealing with treasury bills or bonds, whereas on the contrary here I'll be talking about for example, say debt or equity. So I'll talk about all of these in greater details when I take individual and then get into greater details with respect to the same. Yeah, individual institutions and get into greater details. Then we have the fourth, which is financial instruments. Now that depends upon the term, that is the length of time for which the instrument is being used or traded. That can be short term, medium term and longer term. Short term is usually, as I have told you in my previous lectures, this is up till 1 year. Medium is greater than 1 year but less than 10 years, and then we have long is 10 plus years. So these are the terms in which you talk about. Then we have the type of instruments. They can be either primary and secondary. So this is again financial instruments. So broadly speaking, this is the structure of Indian financial system when I talk about the formal or organized side of it. Let us now look at the unorganized or informal side of the Indian financial system. So in that we have money lenders. So I hope in villages you can still see this operating. Then we have local bankers. For example, in most of the South India, you will see local bankers still active and extending loans at a very high rate of interest. Then we have traders. For example, the traders are giving loans to the farmers. Yeah, to the farmers. So the traders are also getting engaged into lending business. Then we have landlords. Obviously, this is again there was something called as bonded labor, which was very prevalent in most of the parts in India, but now it is banned. So landlords used to do what? They used to give loans to the people, and then if they didn't repay the loan, they used to make them bonded labor in their field. So this is again a big problem with respect to the informal or unorganized Indian financial system. Then we have pawnbrokers. For example, I have a bike. So what I'll do is I'll just give that bike to that fellow and take money from it and money from him, and then I will repay the interest. If I fail to repay the interest, what he'll do is he'll sell that bike and also recover the remaining money from me. So this is how pawnbrokers used to operate in the informal sector or unorganized Indian financial system. So I hope the very brief and very superficial skeleton of the Indian financial system is pretty much clear. In the next lecture, I'll be talking about each of them in greater details. So please stay tuned. Thank you so much.